Arrow, Cambridge, and India.
Mommy, Aiden, techies have got been busy for it. What are you?
May I ask, do you do this sort of thing often on the music hall?
I've never thought about it, perhaps I will one day.
He's not a gentleman. He's not interfering with a poor girl.
But how do you do it, if I may ask?
Oh, simple phonetics, the signs of speech. My profession, also my hope. You see, anyone can spot an Irishman or Yorkshireman by his throat. I can place man within 6 miles. I can place him within 2 miles of London. Sometimes within 2 streets.
Oh, man, shine double stuff on a man like the tower.
But is there a limit in that?
Oh, yes, quite a fair one.
Livermore is out of business and leave a poor girl
alone. Cease this detestable boo-hooing instantly, or seek the shelter of some other place of worship. A woman who utters such depressing and disgusting noises has no right to be anywhere, has no right to live. Remember that you are a human being with a soul and a divine gift of articulate speech, and that your native language is the language of Shakespeare and Milton and the Bible. And don't stand there tooting like a bilious pigeon.
Ow!
Well, look at her, a prisoner of the guns. Condemned by every syllable she utters. By right she should be taken out of harm. For the cold-blooded murder of the English tongue.
Ow!
Ow! Heavens, what a noise. This is what the British population calls an elementary education.
I'm sorry, I think you picked a poor exam.
Did I?
being will give to another. Life.
Thank you.
them on the phonograph over there, so you can turn her on as often as you like, which is some charms for the rule.
This is the young woman, sir.
Oh, no.
But this is the girl I saw about last night. She's no use. I've got all the records I need over this Grove they go, and I'm not going to wait for another son of their aunt. Be off if I don't want you.
Don't you bite so saucy. You're a welcome for yet. Did you tell him I'm from the taxi? Nonsense, girl. What do you think a gentleman like Mr. Higgins cares to hang in? Oh, we all proud, aren't we? Well, then, we won't do the lesson, not him. I'll say so. And if my money's not good enough, I can go elsewhere.
Good enough for what?
Good enough for you. Now, you know, don't you? I've got no lessons I have in the papers and to make no mistake about that.
What do you expect me to say?
Well, if you was a gentleman, you might ask me to sit down, I think. Didn't I tell you I'm bringing you business?
Figuring, shall we ask this baggage to sit down, or shall we throw her out of the window?
No! Throw me my baggage over the pay, our getting lady.
But what is it you want?
I want me a lady of black shop. That's a loud for a cotton cock road. Was I wrong taking us like a spake more genteel? Well, he said he would teach me, and here I am, ready to pay, not asking any favours. They treat me quite as dead. I know what lessons cost, and I'm ready to pay.
How much?
Mary, talking. I thought you'd come off with some chance of getting back to it before you chumped me last night. You had a broken land to a woo!
Sit down!
Won't you sit down, Miss Doolittle?
Oh, what mind if I do?
How much do you propose to pay me for the lessons?
Oh, I know what's right. I'm late. Late for mine is real precious for 18 pence an hour. Well, you wouldn't have to fight after you make savings from the old language. So what gives more?
You know, Biggering, if you consider a shilling, not as a simple shilling, but as a percentage of this income, it works out fully equivalent to 60 or 70 pounds from a study there. By George, it's the biggest offer I've ever had.
60 pounds? Why, you don't want to offer you 60 pounds!
Hold your tongue!
You must be reading.
I did not express myself clearly, because I did not wish to hurt her delicacy.
Oh, no.
But you can't just take a gala like this if you were picking up a pebble on the beach.
But why not?
Why not? You don't know anything about her. What about her parents? She may be married. God!
Yeah, the girl very properly says.
Oh, sorry, me!
I told you, bicycle. The streets will be strewn with bodies of men shooting themselves for your sake by the time I'm done.
Go, it's all been just for you. I don't want the wall to be speech and rage.
Oh, indeed, madam, I very well was pissed. You needn't order the new clothes for her. Throw her out.
Stop this meeting. I won't allow it. Go home to your parents, girl.
Oh, I ain't got no parents.
Yes, yeah, the girl very properly said, I'm a goo-goo parents. What's all the fuss about? She doesn't belong to anybody. She's no use to anybody but me. Now take her,
sir. But what's she come about? Is she behaving?
What should she do with money? She'll have her clothes and her food. She'll only drink if you give her money.
Oh, it's the lie. Now we have a whole side of liquor on me. Oh, so you're a gentleman. Don't let him speak to me like that.
Begins to occur to you that the girl has some feelings.
Oh, dear. No feelings that we need to worry about, have you, Liza?
Miss Higgins, I must know on what terms the girl is to be here. What's to become of her once you've finished your teaching? You must.
What's to become of her if you leave her and answer me that Mrs. Pierce?
That's her own business, Mr. Higgins, not yours.
When I'm done with her, we can throw her back into the gutters, and then it'll be her own business again. That's all right.
He's got feeling hot in him. Okay, but now why won't he come again? The old girl, I've had enough of this.
Eliza?
What?
Eliza?
How do I know what might be in them? A girl being robbed by the likes of you.
That's a good case, Eliza. I eat one half. And you eat the other.
I don't think so, Frost. Most ungrateful, wicked girl, and the angel to eat.
part of this business. I still feel, what do you say, responsible for the girl. I hope it's clearly understood that no advantage is to be taken of her position.
What? That secret, I assure you.
Now, come in, you know what I mean. This is no trifling matter. Are you a man of good character?
Well, women are to say. Have you ever met a man of good character where women are to
say? Yes, I have met many frequently.
Well, I haven't. I find that the moment that a woman becomes friendly with me, she becomes jealous, suspicious, exacting, and a damn nuisance. And I find that the moment I let myself become friendly with her, I become selfish and driven. So here I am, Pickering. I confirmed old Baxter and likely to remain so. After all, Pickering, I am an ordinary man. Desires nothing more than just the ordinary songs. The look exactly as he likes. They do precisely what he wants. An average man am I, of no eccentric rank, who likes to live some free smile. Just an old man. But that old woman in your life, and your serenity is proof. She'll redecorate your home from the cellar to the door, and go on to the enthralling fun of her beholding you. Oh, like a woman in your life.
Thank you.
don't know. Our own mother really don't know. Moved in with a squirrel like that. Left here in a taxi, all by herself. And I've been out for 3 times. And then I get this message from her.
Thank you. ideas, well, men of the world, anyway.
Yes, well, Mrs. Fairchild.
Yes, I think so,
indeed. Governor, I've taken sort of a fancy to you, and if you want the girl, well, I ain't so set on having her back home again. But what I am in for is an arrangement. All I ask is my rights as a father, and you're the last man alive to expect me to let her go for nothing. I can see you're one of them straight sort. What's a £5 up to you, and well, what's a loss? That's a baby.
I think you are true, little, that Mr. Higgins' intentions are entirely honorable.
Of course they are. If I want my warning, I'd ask 50.
You mean to say you sell your dog for £50?
Have you no morals, man?
No. No. I'll be out more about that. Rather than you, if you had as far as me. Not that I mean any harm either. But if I was going to get a bit out of this, why not me too? I mean, what am I ask you? What am I? I'm one of the undeserving poor, that's what I am. Well, think of what that means for a man. It means he's up against a middle-class morality for all time. If ever there's anything going and I've got an in for it, it's always the same old story. You're undeserving, so you can't have it. What we need are as great as any widow's that got money out of six different charities for the death of the same husband. Now, I don't need less than a deserving man. I need more. I don't eat less harder than he does. And well, I do drink a lot more. But, if you would have the help of Mrs. Piss.
Thank you.
flirtation with the girl.
Of course.
Say,
you ain't got no heart, you ain't.
Drop your ages, the flame will remain stationary. That's That's how you know when you've got it correct. And in time, you'll hear what you're doing. Isn't that? In Harvard, Hedisford, and Hampshire, hurricanes hardly ever happen. Now, repeat after me. In Harvard, Hedisford, and Hampshire, hurricanes hardly ever happen. Oh, no. No, I get home, no.
Can I do it over?
Oh, no, please, no. Let's start from the very beginning. Do this. Ha, 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 ha.
Those pebbles really get through.
for Eliza Doolittle. Now go on, Liza.
Bye. in his back.